This is teddygaming VC, and welcome back to another review on the Arrow Season 8, Episode 10. And so, yeah guys, we finally made it to the series finale, and I don't have anything else to say. I don't know if I'm going to do the normal intro for it. I think it deserves for an epic one to go out with a bang for Oliver. Here it is.
You wouldn't have survived, much less come out the other end a hero, if you didn't have a light inside of you.
You have done so much. You have saved so many people's lives.
And he didn't even get a thank you. But today, Starling City Police Department is formally recognizing the individual known as the Arrow.
This city, I always need a Green Arrow.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world. In the war, people talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. Some will call it practice, some will call it luck. But either way, you're going to the history books. Sitting in the Hall of Fame, and the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You can be a hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought would never be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. Are you ever gonna know if you never even try? Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
So start this episode off with a alternate flashback with season 2 where Oliver was able to save his mum from Deathstroke. And this scene's been a weird one like amongst the fans because people don't know whether it's a new scene or it's a deleted old scene, which that makes sense. And so I personally don't really know, but it's a good scene and I'm glad that Manu Bet, I think that's what his name is called. I'm glad he's back for the role. I just can't believe that this series is over. So go back to the present day, and the person who was interviewing Team Arrow last season for the Emerald Archer, interview sort of thing. She basically said that when she did it. She never thought they should be doing it for Emerald, and it's quite sad because you can see everyone come back for it, even people which nobody thought they would ever see again. And yeah, so then Ray and John meet up for sort of like a last time sort of thing, and they're going over how like everything is going. So when they get to the Arrow Cave, they loads of people already back out there. So you see Roy there, Dinah there. Mia's there because Sarah went to the future to get back for her dad's funeral. Which, why didn't Sarah just go and get his son as well? So that's sort of weird. But then it turns out that basically, Felicity's is gone off the rails. Not rails, but like basically, she's ghosting in one because she's mourning everyone and mourning Oliver. And yeah. Then we also see Ragman come back, which is a surprisingly good cameo. Black Canary goes to speak to Quentin Lance about why did everybody else come back and not the Earth Wanderer? And they did a good job here, basically saying that because she was here, they couldn't bring back the other one. So I think that's a good explanation for her being there. So William has been kidnapped by someone Felicity returns to the bunker and gave everyone the orders to go out to everywhere. Now, in this scene, everybody's just talking about like where they're going to go from after the rest of the show's ended. Roy proposed to Thea, and she said yes. There wasn't really too much to it. Ragman explained how he got his rags back, and basically saying that basically they're healed over time. Renee is going to become the mayor. Diana's going to become the chief of the police. Lyle Michaels is feeling sad about saying. I think I fell asleep through that bit. So Mia was the only one who was able to find him. And then turns out that it was a bad guy from season one. And we get a flashback to season one where Oliver is going around killing everybody. And then he gets up to the top, like rooftop, where he's either got the choice to kill the man or he can let him go and live. So Oliver lets him go and live for another day, but he sends him back to, I think it's, I don't know what the police called in this series. But then in the new, or in this Earth Prime, Mia does the same, lets him go, but sends him back to the prison. And it's reported on the news, basically, Oliver's Queen's death has already opened up to a new Age of Heroes. And, it's overall, this episode so far was okay, but very sad, because it's hard to be, I'm very surprised about this, I'll just pull this one off. Especially with the main character dead. That's how Paul sang really good without him being there. And then the last 10 minutes, I think it's probably got to be one of the best moments of Arrow, even though it has nothing to do with Arrow, not like the last few minutes. But there's a big memorial statue for Oliver. Quentin Lawrence goes over saying that how he hated him in the first two seasons, but now he thinks of him as like the best man, better than Lex Luthor in this universe. So that's something, I guess. All hold candles. But I think it's like next day they go to bury him in Oliver's house, which the mansion is back. Turns out that Tony Merlin is alive now. Amika Queen came back to life. The Russian guy, he come back for Oliver's funeral. Barry come back. I'm very surprised he didn't bring back any like other Flash characters for his funeral. But I do guess Flash was just good enough. Carl was there, which I don't think she was really necessary for it. I think he could have chosen someone else, because I wouldn't really associate Carl with Oliver as much as I would do with Barry. And then everybody's just talking about like who should actually say the final words for Oliver's funeral. And then John does it. And this scene is really good. And he talks about like where everybody else is going to be. So, it has a montage where everyone else is going to be going. You see Diana and Laurel driving off somewhere. I can't remember what really happened in this one. I did watch the scene quite a few times. But I think the main thing that came out of this one was basically John was becoming Green Lantern. That's pretty much all you need to know. Then for the final scene, we see what happened in the season 7 finale, which was Felicity going to the Paradise Dimension. We finally see that happening with her going in there, and she sees Oliver for like the first time in like 8 months, sort of. No, like at least a couple of good months, I'd say. And even though this scene's not as strong as it could have been, I think he does still hold a really good place in this episode. And he goes on to say, Felicity mentioned that basically this wasn't the first place which they met, so why they're here. And Oliver says that basically it was the first place that like he met her without her knowing. And we like cut out to the Oliver Queen building. Damn. This was an amazing episode. Oh my god. I don't even know what to think of it. Most of it is like really good. But there is something in this episode which puts it all off. I don't know why, but it feels weird. But it could just be because it's the end of the series. There's no more Arrow, but I don't think that's the case. It just feels weird. like this episode, the whole thing. Yeah, but, I mean, I'm gonna miss you. Yeah, Arrow. I know I thought I'd be saying this here, but yeah, even like, you know, Crisis Part 5, they were talking about Oliver. I'm gonna do that right now. So, Oliver, yeah, you've given me a lot of joy over the past 8 years. Even through the bad and the good times of your show, you've always given me something to look forward to. Yeah, I'll just leave you guys with this little music video, which it does not hold up to what the legacy has provided us with. Goodbye, Arrow.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where it starts. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes, and that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. I tried carrying the weight of the world, but I only have two hands. I hope I get the chance to travel the world, but I don't have any plans. I wish that I could stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Oh, life's a game made for everyone, and love is a prize. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. I didn't know. Lost.